You're watching UNICEF television. A year has passed since a 34-day war broke out between Hezbollah and Israel, plunging Lebanon into a sudden and intense humanitarian emergency. The conflict killed over 1,000 people in Lebanon, injured more than 4,000, and forced 900,000 to flee their homes in the south of the country. UNICEF and its partners rapidly responded to provide families with clean water, essential pediatric medicine and vaccines, hygiene kits, and other supplies critical to keeping children healthy in displacement conditions. One of the biggest physical threats to children came in the form of 1 million cluster bomblets. UNICEF immediately began distributing warning information with a simple message: if you see an unfamiliar object, don't approach, don't touch, and report it to the authorities. One of the major areas of work for UNICEF has been to restore drinking water supply for children and their families in the south of Lebanon. In addition to progress in rebuilding infrastructure, UNICEF and its partners have been working to restore normalcy to children's lives through school, as well as recreational and self-expression activities. Christine, age 13, lives in Nabatieh area of South Lebanon. She is participating in a special summer program supported by UNICEF and run by partner NGO InterSOS. She and her peers have been coming to a cultural community center each morning to learn about a specific topic ranging from first aid to caring for the environment.
Although children are changing a lot, they are still afraid. During the war, there was a lot of bombarding, a lot of heavy noises that were really frightening. So this is why I think they can't take this out of their minds.
As Lebanon continues to recover from last year's war while struggling to cope with current instability, UNICEF's support of community-based initiatives like this one are more important than ever.
I came here 2 days and I was having much fun that I could describe it. It's something, it's really a magical place that everybody is thinking about it and wishing to come here.
Promoting tolerance and peace between people of different religious and social background is key to stability in the country's future. And the best place to start is with children and young people. This is Natasha Ikoli reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.